Welcome, friends, family, faculty and staff, members of the Board of Trustees, alumni, parents, grandparents, to these 137th commencement exercises at Northfield Mount Hermon. And congratulations to you, the class of 2020, for earning the diplomas I'm honored to bestow upon you today. Today we come together, virtually, to recognize and celebrate the class of 2020. When we began the year together in Memorial Chapel, who could have predicted what the year would bring us? Yet here we are, sitting in front of our screens. I'm sorry for this. I'm sorry for you, your parents, siblings, extended family members, and friends around the world. My heart aches for all of you because today is truly something special. And it's much better celebrated in person. I also want to acknowledge your many friends and advocates here on campus. Your NMH family stands with you in solidarity. So here we are, living in a world few would have imagined only a few months ago. Yes, we are sad. We're frustrated. We're angry. Let's own it. It's not what we expected. And certainly, this is not what we wanted. Now let's let this go. We cannot change the circumstances in which we find ourselves, but we can choose how we react to this moment in time and the lessons we will learn. Here's my choice. I choose you. I believe in you and your promise. You have risen together in profound ways. You have conquered unforeseen circumstances. You have met my generation's limitations with patience. You have responded to frustration and fear with kindness and love. In short, you have acted with humanity and purpose in ways small and quite significant. David Thoreau, who lived most of his life not far from here, wrote in his journal more than 150 years ago, "Though I do not believe that a plant will spring up where no seed has been, I have great faith in seed. Convince me that you have seed there, and I am prepared to expect wonders. I expect wonders from you. I see something extraordinary in you. I sense your shared purpose. I feel strength in your resilience. I understand the power of your bond with one another, and I take comfort in your connection to this place on the hillside in Gill, Massachusetts. Indeed, you are seeds well nourished, and we need to take a moment to offer thanks to the many people who have nourished you so well. I hope you will join with me in your own ways and in your own time to offer gratitude. First, I thank your first teachers, your parents, for the love they have offered you. I thank them for trusting you with us here at Northfield Mount Hermon. This is a precious gift, and we have sought to honor their sacred trust at all times. I thank your extended families, your siblings, grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins, those who have loved you and supported you in ways that only family members are able to do so. I also ask these family members to continue to hold you tight in the years to come. I offer my thanks to the many unknown to most of us, people who have given their time and treasure and talent so that you can benefit from this opportunity here at Northfield Mount Hermon. This includes trustees, past and present, benefactors and volunteers, and the tens of thousands of alums whose footsteps you follow. I am thankful for their steadfast dedication to our remarkable school. Finally, I want to thank your NMH teachers, coaches, advisors, and mentors who have loved you, nurtured you, challenged you to be your best self. They have known you. They have loved you. And now we stand together in sending you off. You are ready, and we believe in you. Well done to all the members of the class of 2020 as we celebrate you and your significant accomplishments. As you stretched and strengthened your heads, hearts, and hands during your time at Northfield Mount Hermon. Our school song, Jerusalem, continues to remind us to always call upon our better angels as we take up the hard work and challenges of making our world a better place. The words are in your programs. Feel free to join in singing with our special commencement 2020 faculty choir. I am pleased to introduce you to this year's senior order, Olisa Tasi Amade, who is coming to us today from Port Harcourt, Nigeria. Olisa's well-known presence on the campus for his positive personality and friendly demeanor. He definitely moves to his own beat. Whether he's DJing popular campus events, performing with World Music Combo, supporting fellow students as a global ambassador, running on the track, or even helping to hand out a game day uniforms to NMH athletes in his work job, one constant is Olisa's huge smile. As a captain of the NMH track team, Olisa has a knack for being the big brother to his younger teammates and peers, and his coaches appreciate the time and energy he spends with others. He readily helps them to adjust to increased expectations on the track. And over his 4 years at NMH, Olisa has gained our respect and our appreciation as a genuine, hardworking, persistent, and energetic individual. Sounds like humanity and purpose to me. And I'm sure that he will continue to make a difference in the upcoming years at Syracuse University. Graduates, families, and members of the NMH community, please join me in welcoming the class of 2020 Senior Order, Olisa Tasi Amade.
Good day, class of 2020. I'd like to thank you all in advance for listening to the words I'm about to say. If life were predictable, it would cease to be life. It will be without flavor. Eleanor Roosevelt. We start to understand the meaning of our lives when we realize we're at grace with one. For the past 4 years, I've stared into the night and asked myself, if I closed my eyes today and never woke up, would I be at peace with the things that happened? Many times, actually all the time, I met with fear. Not of death, no. Fear of imperfect conclusions. Even though that has proven to be the outcome of our last year, ironically, I found great joy in that. A friend of mine told me there are times in life that require certain stillness to reflect on the places we have been, appreciate the now that we are in, and try to understand where we are going. Last spring, I took a trip to Kenya in hopes of training for my upcoming track season. The hot tropical sunshine that fell on my shoulders put delight in my heart. It seemed like I had other plans. I tore my hamstring and was unable to walk, let alone run. Soon, life became filled with anger and unbearable. I ghosted my parents for weeks, shut out the care of my friends, and took for granted the love I shared with a close companion. This was my first unfinished ending. I lamented how unfair the world was because I let my whole life become about running rather than making it a part of the essence of my life. I had been so conditioned by false entitlement that I let myself think that the absence of pain and the presence of assured closure were exclusive to my own existence. The authenticity of the pain I felt was more real than the breaths I took to survive my days, because those were what my days became: survival. A year later, I found myself coming second to states, qualifying for nationals, and an email notification at 7:52 p.m. from Brian, letting me know that my spring season at NMH would not be happening. My second unfinished ending. This time was different. This time the urge for childish manifestations of misleading sorrow were replaced by immeasurable gratitude for life. I was shown that change does not always ask for consent. Starting a clothing brand or finding an infatuated taste for anime series would never have come if life decided to be predictable. As I go to bed, I'm at peace with the reality that I might not wake up tomorrow. I might never run again. I might not be able to sit in the dining hall and encounter the lives of every great person that sits amongst us today. I've always known my time at NMH, this home, would come to an end. Accepting this was always as hard a pill to swallow as hearing Chris tell my class we had 60 pages of reading for the night. Much to my annoyance growing up, the unexpected end of something meant a failure or a goal unachieved. As I stand before you today, at the end of our time together, has become an indication of adventurous school days, long study halls, exciting intramurals, a successful experience of long-lasting memories that have proven not to be dreams deferred, but dreams fulfilled. An indication that the stories these past 4 years that we have written have meaning. Donovan Livingston, Harvard class of 2016, said, "Our stories are the ladder that make it easier for us to touch the stars. So keep on climbing, keep on writing, and tell your stories, even if all those stories don't have a resolution." At this moment, understand that you are here for which you are purposed. You'll achieve all you are meant to. Caught up in the fun and drama of a existence that we think has predestined destinations, there will be many unavoidable stops, many unfinished walks. So live. Pour out your soul to the uncertainty of life. Take down the walls of fear, of anxiety, of hope that you will see another day. Life was never meant to be controlled or direct, so live intentionally. Life was never meant to be predictable or measured, so live eccentrically. Focus on the days, the minutes, the second. Live specifically. Your life will be broken down many times over and over and over again. But in the end, it will still be your head, your heart, and your hands. Thank you.
Thank you, Elisa. Now for the most important award that NMH presents to those students who qualify. Will the candidates for the diplomas please rise and present themselves at this time? Yes, members of the class of 2020, you should rise to make this official. By the authority of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and the Board of Trustees, and in recognition of your successful completion of the requirements set by the faculty, I award you this diploma and admit you to the distinguished company of alumni of Northfield Mount Hermon. Congratulations to all members of the NMH class of 2020. To complete the conferring of your NMH diplomas, your devoted class advisors, Kim Shearer and Chris Ramirez, will read your names and share an image of your diploma, and yes, you, virtually in Memorial Chapel.
Walter George Ainsworth, Akawat Amatayakun, Clemente Jose Arcuch Puig, Eliza Torchia Atwood, Florida Ella Auerbach, Marcel Hennington Awori, Noah Babala Money, Amelia Anna Bacon, Connor Joseph Bagden, Wyatt Aiden Bandy Page, Bao Yu Shun, Ella Bathory Peeler. Charlotte. Elise Bosha. Adham Bayumi. Alexander Beatuich II. Benta Lisette Bechtel. Celia Marie Begonia. Arjan Bektamirova. Camilia Bergalijeva. Luca Kai Berger. Jack Benjamin Brazier. Grant Douglas Brayo. Lucinda Margaret Brock. Connor Edmund Burke. Adia Rashamba Burrows.
Greer Catherine Caligione. Benjamin Dove Callahan Gold. Eileen Jamgir Chinova Cameron. Cow Wing Kelly Cow. Rafaela Capilate Veole Veda. Adam Martin Carlisle. Maya Oceana Castro Santos. Joshua Lewis Chase. Sydney Elizabeth Chase. Diane Kiki Chen. Yu Cheng Chung. Asher Sung Lee Choi. Chen An Cho. Emily Chow. Aiden Buckley Conti. Andrew D. Cormier. Johan Jose Cruz Hernandez. Jacob Gear Curtis. Sean Zajan Damon. Joseph Bradford D. Liam Dillon. Lillian Olivia Dorless. Luke Madiket Dow. Maria Achesarate Fernandez. Elijah Alfonso Joseph Edwards.
Alexander Charles Ehrenthal. Darius Jason Irvin. Conrad James Fallon. Cindy Fan. Reese Michael Farrell. Owen Matthew Finn. Elizabeth Marie Biggie Flynn. Ella Kate Fontaine. Isaac Bond Foster. Natalie Claire Foster. Grady Robert Friedman. Caitlin, Deborah, Anne Gatza. Olivia Santigiallo Geddes. Benjamin Go. Brianne, Jenna, Stephanie Davis Gome. Elliot, Peter Gooley. Thomas Aiden Graves. Maya Elizabeth Green. Arda Goulon. Kamari Hathaway. Matilda Jizuko Haddock. Tehun Han. Shamik Ronell Hargrave. Connor James Halsley. Sean Sven Heller.
Sonia Marisa Hernandez. Hunter Duke Hawkinsmith. Bruno Holters. Winston Howard Hoffler. Max Jameson Horowitz. Hui Xiong. Drake Alistair Hunt. Aknazar Janabek. Eric Jara. Tanea Aliyah Jolly. Daniel Lucian Jones. Harrison Owen Jones. Kohaku Kanamori. Claudia Kasman. Marina Oakley Cater. Charles Stanwood Kenyon. Harrison Paul Kerber. Hannah Miriam Katorski. Hyunho Kim. Marcus Raymond Kinney. Garrett Powers Kirk. Alyssa Kravchen. Kyunghong Joseph Kwan. Owen Walker LeBombard. Benjamin Bromley Lance.
Michaela Sophia Lawyer. Yingyuk Gabriel Lee. Saw Young Lee. Yang Hua Lee. Grace Lee. Samantha R. Lahaney. Yung Yang Lim. Jude Lindell. Caleb Ahmad Littlepool. Luke Foley Lonergan. Luca Raphael Lukashevich. Hadija Suleiman Mahmoud. Jack Michael Malloy. Muhammad Ali Manji. Caleb Robert Martin. Mara Jean Matthews. Isabel Jin Mei. Emily Ann McAllister. Mark William McClure. Gavin Reese McGuckin. Charles Bradford McLaughlin. Sage Clara Michael. Jessica Raina Mitchell. Omolola Victoria Mojeed Balogun. Quentin Rourke Moliterno.
Prince Kushinda Moses. Dylan Patrick Murtaugh. Zachary Judd Necklace. Miyu Nakajima. Kwame Nduba. Alvin Sulam Nye. Hien Nguyen. Wenhung Lee. Viet Tung Ling Nguyen. Skylar Merrifield Neiman. Alexandra Muse Nolan. Jem O'Condon. Sarah Junyong O'Keefe. Moboluin Irulu Wabami Sasainin Olerin Moya. TJ Onosude. Danil Ozernin. Manuela Pacheco. Ziong Pen. Elin Pandalaki. Minyoung Park. Zara Madeline Hosan Pei. Eling Stephen Pong. Emily Pham. Wong Mai Pham. Elizabeth Catherine Platzner.
Philip Rathborn Wilmerding Saladekas. Mika Cornelia Perba. Muhammad Redswan Bin Muhammad Rafa. Salma Ramirez Sanchez. Aiden Hack Reeves. Brian David Riker. Ho Yoon Jaden Rue. Lewis Benjamin South. Jaden Sadie Sama. Orla Emmett Schwartz. Matthew Brendan Shapiro. Ethan Shore Shepherd. Polina Chkrupa. Mason Whitney Franklin Shoshone. Samuel Levy Silverstein. Lena Hannah Lewis Smalo. Olisa Tasi Amadi. Zachary Martin Taylor. Keone Steve David Terrell Perica. Ishan Takor. Connor Ethan Theriot. Jack Robert Ferrier. Claire Elizabeth Thomas. Christopher Gawa Ma Throdson. Althea Maeve Tierney.
Angie Tran. Huang Ming Truong. Edward Trutayev. Autumn Iowa Twilly. Sage Elise Valente. Benjamin Daniel Van Winkle. William Edgar Shannon Verdon. Annika Wren Fulton Voorhees. Michael Wong. Ronald C. Hang Wang. Francis Holiday Weir. Garrett Samuel Weil. Daniela Rita Weldon. Henry Hortison Wells. Margaret Emerson Witt. Benjamin Jarzin Walmsley. Adrian Wong. Ashley Elena Risley. Junrong Wu. Jenny Young. Maria Zabora. Fengkai Zhuang. Irene Agnes Zhang. Yicheng Zhang. Haochen Zhao. Haolin Zhang. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Congratulations, and welcome to the Northfield Mount Hermon Alumni Association. It is now my pleasure to introduce our 137th commencement speaker. Earlier this spring, I met with the senior officers to hear their thoughts on who they wanted as a commencement speaker. My only request, focus our attention on our own community of alumni and parents. We talked through who they wanted, and they quickly began to focus on the idea of finding a journalist or author in our ranks. Well, it did not take us long to identify a person whose success has brought honor to Northfield Mount Hermon. Ellen Spraggins is a proud member of the class of 1972. She is a writer, speaker, and workshop leader whose focus is the inner wisdom that lies within all of us, no matter how old we are. Ellen is the author of multiple books, including a New York Times bestseller, What I Know Now, Letters to My Younger Self. She is a journalist whose resume includes writing weekly columns with the New York Times, contributing to numerous widely circulating magazines, and serving as a contributing editor at Smart Money, Business Week, Newsweek, and Inc. While at Newsweek, she won the National Press Club's Consumer Journalism Award, and later, the Clarion Award. Today, Ellen continues to write and speak regularly. She travels throughout the country and has been a featured speaker with leading corporations, including Microsoft, Goldman Sachs, Genentech, Johnson & Johnson, Novartis, Citibank, and many other organizations. Ellen graduated magna cum laude from Barnard College in 1977 and cum laude from Northville Mount Hermon in 1972. She lives with her husband and fellow NMH graduate, John Whitty, class of 1970, in Malvern, Pennsylvania. It's now my pleasure to introduce you to Ellen Spraggins. Ellen?
Thank you, Brian, for that kind introduction. Greetings to the faculty of this beloved school, and a warm hello to the proud parents of the class of 2020. And to all 201 newly christened graduates, let me be the first to welcome you with open arms to the ranks of Northfield Mount Hermon alumni. We are 30,000 strong around the world, all shaped indelibly by our school. You may have noticed that I'm wearing the wrong hat. Instead of a mortarboard, I'm wearing a fascinator. Why? Because this is not what I expected. The circumstances are not what I expected today. This was not part of the plan. I thought I'd be on campus wearing a cap and gown. You thought you'd be hugging family and friends, taking a zillion pictures and videos. We expected this particular day, and the next one, and the one after that, to unspool for us just the way we planned. Instead, we are each in our silos, spread around the world, unable to touch each other, unable to walk our beautiful green and gold campus one more time, unable to join together on one of the most important days of your life. This is not what we expected. This was never part of the plan. What happens when the world veers off course and lands a punch to the gut? I am no more an expert on pandemics than you are, but I have spent a chunk of my career collaborating with well-known people on writing letters to their younger selves during a time when their world veered off course, a time when everything in their lives turned upside down. And so I suggest three things happen to us when our world collapses. First, what the hell? We are incredulous. We are indignant. What do you mean I can't go to my graduation? I can't go to my summer job. Can't travel with friends. And on and on. The news that we are not in control of our lives does not land well. I think of Jane Kaczmarek, the actress best known as the mom in the television series Malcolm in the Middle. From high school through her 20s, her life unfolded perfectly. She got the lead in every high school play. She won the best acting prize at Yale Drama School. She got the best agent. She moved to Los Angeles. And then got her first job from her first audition on her first day there. Yep. This continued for 6 solid years, years during which she switched fancy boyfriends like pieces of jewelry. But at 32, she experienced 3 devastating professional and personal failures. She says in her letter to her younger self, "You believe that you deserved success because you worked hard, but you haven't been a good friend or even a good girlfriend. Now failure is busting you wide open so that you can learn what true success means." This is the second stage, being busted wide open. We hate our new condition. We suffer. Many of you have suffered being ripped apart from friends, being ripped apart from sports and activities that you loved and that defined you, being taken away from senior year milestones that you anticipated for years. Here is where denial comes in handy. Mike Krzyzewski, or Coach K, the most winning coach in the history of Division I college basketball, suffered for a long time with debilitating pain. Rather than check it out, he ignored it. Told he needed a hip replacement, he denied it. He was afraid. He could beat this pain. So he waited and waited, eventually having to sit on a stool on the edge of the basketball court while he coached the Blue Devils. The lack of on-court time with his players caused the team to lose a national championship they should have won, he believes. For a man with an unshakable competitive drive, this was crushing. Not what he expected, not part of the plan. As he says in his letter, "Sometimes your strength turns out to be a weakness. You're not Superman, Mike. Be smarter." So, this is how we begin to accept the unacceptable. Some of you have lost friends or family members. You are being forced to bear the unbearable. We wish for what was, not what is. At this point, you may be wondering, what happened to that encouraging, inspirational, positive commencement message you were expecting? Well, here it is. Pain and suffering and unexpected circumstances are actually catalysts for growth. We change. We learn. We accept that our plans have been upended. This is the third thing that happens. That change of your perspective can generate something astonishing, renewal, innovation, a great upwelling of our individual and collective imaginations. I cannot tell you what that means for you individually, but I can tell you that I believe you will rise to the occasion. The dreams of yours that were derailed, they will resurface stronger than ever, take a new shape and a new urgency. Believe it or not, this is the moment to dream bigger than ever, to pursue with the head, the heart, and the hand, and keep pursuing what you care most about, even if the path twists and turns. Because that's one thing COVID-19 has taught us already. Twists and turns and setbacks will surely come. But I believe that you, class of 2020, can adapt and prevail. The last thought I'd like to leave you with is another COVID lesson. Actually, I'd say a COVID gift. In forcing us apart, the scourge has elevated the importance of being together. In forcing me to wear a mask to protect you, it has underscored our interconnectedness. I believe that your class of 2020, more than any class that has come before, will find the power of human connection magnified and will honor it forever. Congratulations to each of you, and I can't wait to see you in real life.
Ellen, thank you for sharing your words with us. I'm touched by the flexibility and openness you have modeled for us as our commencement speaker. You have been so understanding as we've shifted our plans. Thank you. And I agree with you. The class of 2020 will make us all proud as they embrace the opportunity for growth, dream big dreams, and hold true to our school's mission. And I, too, look forward to celebrating them with you in person. Benediction means to send forth with good words. Our school chaplain, Dr. Lee Ellen Strawn, will offer the benediction. Then the Commencement 2020 faculty choir will lead us in the singing of the Northfield benediction.
It is our tradition at Northfield Mount Hermon to end our ceremonial gatherings with a benediction, a giving of good wishes, a giving of blessings. And so today, at the close of this commencement for the NMH class of 2020, I share with you sentiments of all of this community that has shaped you and is now launching you into your next steps of life. I hope that these blessings, which have been bestowed upon countless other graduates of this school, can be a reminder of who you are as lamplighters in a world that truly needs you. So, friends, on this day and forevermore, may you be blessed with the power of your education, a true privilege that will not cease to call forth your response daily. And as you have remarkably demonstrated to us in these past couple of months, may you continue to find the resilience and creativity that allows you to be lifelong learners, whatever may be the circumstances. May you be blessed with courage to envision a future where your life feels complete because of your kindness towards others, even when you suffer from concern for their welfare. May you be blessed with a passion for what is possible and a conviction to move your ideals into actionable steps. May you be blessed with a steadiness that gives you the balance to hold both the joys and sorrows in life, and may you be blessed to know the grounding strength of community that upholds you through meaningful relationships. And in all that you do, may you always be propelled by hope, a hope that opens you to the humanity of your neighbor and stirs you to live out yours. Wherever you unpack your bag and with whomever you share your meal, carry our blessings with you as you find your place in the world. We will continue to hold you in our hearts and prayers. We are proud of you, NMH Class of 2020. Go forth in peace and with great expectations. Amen.
The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. And be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance, his countenance upon thee, and give thee peace, and give peace.
Thank you, Lee Ellen. Thank you, Sheila, Craig, Steve, Jay, Meg, and David. On behalf of Northfield Mount Hermon, I thank you all for sharing this celebratory and historic occasion with us. As soon as we are safely able to bring back the class of 2020 to campus, we will do so. Until that time, take heart in our community's shared commitment to you and to one another. We will not let go of you. Not today, not when you return for your class celebration, not ever. I leave you with the wise words from Lord Tennyson's poem, Ulysses. I am a part of all that I have met. Indeed, we are a part of one another, forever connected to our shared experiences in Northfield Mount Hermon and our common mission to serve and lead with humanity and purpose. We conclude Northfield Mount Hermon's 137th commencement with the Class of 2020 class song, The Climb, sung by senior members of the NMH Singers and Select Women's Ensemble, and a poignant NMH slideshow produced by our own Glenn Mitchell. Again, congratulations to the graduates of the NMH Class of 2020 and to their families, friends, and all their NMH teachers and supporters on campus.
I will not. I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on. Cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the
thank you.